it going, everyone? Chris here, and welcome back to another Nintendo E3 leak discussion video. In today's video, we are actually going to be taking a look at an extremely interesting and credible new leak, because not only does this leak come directly from Vergeben, who is a pretty credible leaker in the eyes of many, but he actually correctly predicted a bunch of stuff that ended up happening during the Xbox presentation for E3. However, guys, as always, and I cannot stress this enough, just because Vergeben managed to predict a bunch of new information, that does not mean that this leak is going to end up being 100% real, so make sure you guys take it with a grain of salt and realize that I'm talking about this just for fun. If you guys would like to read along while I talk, you can find a link to the original post in the description bar down below, and now, with all that out of the way, I have to tell you guys where this leak came from. So guys, this leak was sent in to me by one of my subscribers on my Discord server, so if you guys haven't already joined up, you can find a link to my Discord as well as links to all of my social media presences, such as my Twitter and Patreon, in the description right down below. Also guys, we are going to be giving away a couple of Nintendo eShop gift cards over on my girlfriend's channel once she hits 1,000 subscribers, so if you guys haven't already subscribed to her channel, you can find a link to it in the description right down below for your chance to win an eShop gift card. And now guys, with all of that out of the way, this leak comes from GameFAQs, and once again, it is posted by Vergeben. So with all of that being said guys, let's go ahead and take a look at what he has to say. So guys, like I said, this leak comes from GameFAQs.com, and it is posted by Vergeben. It starts by saying, "I must mention that I don't know the current order of Smash DLC characters, or if only the second character will be revealed. Keep that in mind, please. With that out of the way, I don't know how much of this info I have gotten is going to be revealed at E3, but I will start by saying that I know that Collection of Mana is due for an E3 reveal. Two Saga games, Romancing Saga 3 and the Saga Scarlet Grace expanded port, will be revealed and shown off at E3. Then, the Xbox One successor, Project Scarlet, will come during holiday 2020. I heard last year that a new Perfect Dark game is in development for it. I don't know when that game will be announced, but it was worth bringing that up. Minecraft Dungeons is coming in early 2020, and it is also going to be released on the Switch. After that, Elden Ring looks to be set in a dying world. Elden Ring will be revealed at Microsoft's E3 conference, so will Tales of Arise. Code Vein is coming on September 27th. Dragon Ball Project Z has Kakarot as a subtitle now. Dragon Ball Z Kakarot is the new name from my understanding. It's coming in 2020 now from what I hear. Deathloop is a new game by Dishonored People. The Elder Scrolls Blades coming to the Switch with a new update. After that, Fallout 76 is getting a Battle Royale mode from what I heard, which is funny enough that I am inclined to believe they got that desperate to try and save it by adding that. Also, getting an update where human NPCs are back. Then we have Dying Light 2, the story of Aiden, not Pierce I guess, and he's probably infected. That is coming out in spring of 2020. Then, Cyberpunk 2077 has a character that looks like John Wick, with a cyber arm apparently. That new Contra game that I heard about, I got an update on that. It is isometric but fully 3D, and doesn't look that great. I currently don't know if it is going to be revealed at E3, but I know of a Metroid 5. The new 2D styled Metroid is in development. I'm not certain of the developer. I have heard two different names that could be behind it last year, but it seemed more speculative, so it's probably not worth mentioning. And finally, a new WarioWare game for the Switch is another thing that I have heard about for a while that is in development. I don't know if this is being revealed at E3, not at the moment at least. So now that we've gone over the entire post, let's talk about it a little bit. So guys, now that we're going to go ahead and move into the discussion phase, I just want to give you guys a quick disclaimer that I did not watch the Xbox presentation. I'm not a huge fan of Microsoft or Xbox or anything else like that, and I figured that if something big was going to happen, like they were going to announce a character in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate like Master Chief or Banjo-Kazooie, it probably happened during Nintendo's Direct, so forgive me if I make any mistakes on this guys, but I did decide to go ahead and look through all this new stuff to see if it all was confirmed and if Vergeben actually got this right. So when looking through all the things that he claimed were going to be on this Direct, the first thing that I found extremely interesting was the Xbox One successor, which is codenamed Project Scarlet, and its release date of holiday 2020. Now, when I was first thinking about this, I'm like, well, lots of people believe that we were going to be getting a new Xbox console at least announced at E3, but probably the most interesting part about this is that Vergeben correctly predicted the codename. Now, for those of you guys who don't know, when companies like Nintendo or Xbox or Sony are working on a new console or something that they want to keep secretly, like, really under wraps, they will give them code names so that if it gets leaked, all that it leaks out is the code name, and people are just going to have to speculate because of that. Well, Vergeben actually got Project Scarlet correct, which, for those of you guys who don't know, is the official code name of the new Xbox console that's going to be releasing in holiday 2020. So yeah, guys, Vergeben definitely has credibility. Not only that, guys, but Dragon Ball Project Z, which is now Dragon Ball Z Kakarot, was officially announced by Sony the other day with a release date of early 2020. So, this is definitely a real leak. I understand that Vergeben has been a little bit shaky with his credibility, getting some stuff right here and then other stuff wrong there, but, you know, considering he got all of this stuff correct, I have no reason to doubt that the rest of the information he gave out is credible. So guys, if you were curious about everything that Vergeben got right on this post, let's go ahead and talk about them really quickly. So first of all, the Xbox One successor, Project Scarlet, coming out in holiday 2020, yep, that's confirmed. Then Minecraft Dungeons is coming in early 2020, yep, that's also confirmed, and it was not confirmed on Switch quite yet, it'll probably be announced tomorrow during Nintendo's E3 Direct. After that, Elden Ring was set in a dying world, and Elden Ring's revealed at Microsoft's E3 conference, check check. Then, Dragon Ball Project Z has Kakarot as a subtitle now, yep, another thing that's confirmed. Elder Scrolls Blades is coming to the Switch with a new update, again, this happened. Fallout 76 getting a Battle Royale mode, that also happened. Dying Light 2 Story of Aiden, that's confirmed. And Cyberpunk 2077 has a character that looks like John Wick with a cyber arm apparently, that also happened. So, he probably got about half of the things right so far, but considering there's still a ton of time left in E3, I'm sure we're going to be seeing this, more of this at least, over the next couple of days. So now let's go ahead and talk about my favorite part of this leak, being the Nintendo stuff. Now, one of the things that we have to talk about first is Banjo-Kazooie, because if you guys weren't already aware, Vergeben came out a couple of days ago and he said that he was 99% sure that Banjo-Kazooie would be making an appearance in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate as DLC. Now, many people believe that Banjo-Kazooie is actually going to get revealed tomorrow during Nintendo's E3 Direct, but as of now, we do not have any official confirmation on the matter. It's entirely possible that we get Banjo-Kazooie, but it could also be a different character. Now, personally, considering that Vergeben has gotten so much stuff right in just the past couple of days, like, I have absolutely no reason to doubt that we're going to be seeing Banjo-Kazooie in Smash Ultimate tomorrow. However, just given the fact that he said it's a 99% chance and not a 100% chance, I am a little bit worried, but once again, we are just going to have to wait and see. After that, apparently we're going to be getting a new WarioWare game, and I'm actually pretty happy about that. Now, I know a lot of you guys may not care about WarioWare or anything else like that, but I actually really love that game franchise. I think it's one of Nintendo's most underrated franchises, so seeing a WarioWare game come to the Nintendo Switch that I can play hopefully with my friends just sounds absolutely awesome, and I really hope this ends up getting announced tomorrow with like a holiday release window, just so we don't have to wait too long for it. Just because I know it's not like the biggest game franchise once again, but there are some people like myself that really love it and would love to play it with all of our friends. And finally guys, we have something that I think most of you guys are probably going to be the most excited for, being Metroid 5. Now, I know a lot of us are really hoping for more information on Metroid Prime 4, but considering that they had to start development over from scratch, we're probably not going to get any information on it anytime soon. However, I definitely think that this, along with the Metroid Prime trilogy, is a great way to hold us over until Metroid Prime 4. Now, if you guys have never played any of the Metroid games that are in 2D, they're actually pretty fun, and I definitely recommend giving them a try. I personally haven't played any of them in a while, just because I've been more, like, in love with the Metroid Prime series. Like, I definitely prefer 3D games over 2D games, I think, but I know that a lot of you hardcore Metroid fans are super looking forward to another 2D-style Metroid adventure, so for all of you guys, I am extremely happy. However, guys, overall, do I think that Vergeben has credibility and this leak is actually going to end up happening? I mean, yeah, I definitely think that everything that Vergeben said is definitely going to end up happening just because, once again, he has a pretty good track record overall, and although he did get some stuff incorrectly before, like, we have to remember that this is a whole new era of Vergeben with new sources, so I definitely think that Vergeben has some credibility. However, guys, let me know your thoughts about this leak and Vergeben in the comment section down below. Do you guys believe that this leak is real, and would you guys be happy if it was? Why or why not? Thank you guys all so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe, share, and like, and I will see you guys next time. Take care.